Hello friends, here in this video we will see ergonomic considerations in design. Ergonomic considerations in design. Now when we say ergonomic means it means relation between man and machine. So when we are talking about ergonomics, it is considered when we are designing any product, and it means that the relation between man and machine. And what is this relation? If we are operating any machine, then the effort applied by us, it should be less. And at the same time, the various controls or parts of the machine, they should be easily accessible to the operator. So for designing any of the machines, we consider ergonomics. Ergonomics are considered while designing hand levers, foot levers, buttons, knobs, switches, etc. So here I have written about ergonomics. See, ergonomics, we see it in day-to-day life, but we are not aware of this term. Suppose if there is a switch which is to be operated, then that switch should be located at such a distance that we won't have to extend our hand too much. It means the switch button should be within our reach. That is called as ergonomics. Means we should not get tired just by pressing the button of that switch. It should be within our reach, not beyond that. So if the switch is within our reach, it means it has been designed by ergonomic considerations. Similarly, if we are using some hand levers or foot levers, like for example, when we are driving a car, in that case, we have a foot lever, that is the accelerator, brake and clutch pedals, all are foot levers. So to operate that foot levers, they should be closer to the feet. It should not happen that our seat is behind, we have to come forward and then apply the force at the pedal. So ergonomic consideration, it takes care of such situation that whatever the hand levers, foot levers, buttons, knobs, switches, etc. they are there in a machine or a vehicle, they should be easily accessible for us, means it should be within our range. We should not have to extend our hand too much. We should not have to extend our feet too much. It should be within that reach. So while designing any component, if we are taking that man-machine relationship into account, that is called as ergonomic considerations. Next, the basic need for ergonomics is to reduce human effort, that is to decrease the amount of force which we apply. Like for example, I'll give the example of a car. Suppose if we are driving a car, in that case, if there is too much distance between the driving seat and the steering wheel, then also it becomes difficult to drive. Or in other words, if the steering wheel is very close to us, then also it becomes difficult. So the distance should be maintained in such a way that the effort applied by us is less, At the same time, the steering wheel is not very close or very far away from us. That consideration is called as ergonomics. Next, if we are driving a vehicle and the location of the mirrors, which are the rear view mirrors, they should be in such a way that just while we are sitting in one position and seeing into the mirror, we can look what is there behind. Means we don't have to get up from the seat, we have to look sideways. That is called as ergonomics, that the machine should be accessible. How much friendly a machine becomes, that part is called as ergonomics. Next, when we are moving in trains, at that time also the seat arrangement, the seat on which we are seated, that should also be designed as per the human body. It should be anatomically designed, because for long journeys it should not happen that just by sitting on a particular seat we get tired. So such considerations where we are making the human effort less, where we get less tired, that is called as ergonomics. So I hope in this video the topic of ergonomics is really understood.